Hooray! Hi!
Hi!
Wow. Number five!
That's right. It's alive!
Johnny Five is alive.
Wow, I'm so excited. We made it to number five.
I did it. We're
wow. Great. Cheers.
Cheers.
Yay. Happy Monday.
Yay. It had nothing to do with any of them.
Yay.
Yay.
Good evening, ladies and germs, and welcome to Cosplay Cabaret Workshop. I'm Lindsay.
I'm Vanessa.
Who are you?
I am not Lindsay or Vanessa. My name is Keegan.
Ta-da!
Hello, Internet.
Hello, Internet. So Keegan is a very special, super awesome, fun times friend. And she is our guest for this evening.
She's wonderful.
She is. I know, right? She's like a cat.
Or pigeon.
Yep.
Yeah. Pigeon cat.
Cat pigeon?
Yeah.
Like a pigeon. Pegasus?
Mm-hmm.
With rainbows.
Feathered neck?
Uh-huh. Rainbows in the sun. Wow.
That's kind of what you are.
It's kind of deep.
Yeah. Can I have all my toes?
No.
Damn,
you have all but one.
You need to have like a club foot, like the pigeons of San Francisco.
Yeah. Well, I gotta represent my neighborhood.
It's a peg leg.
Right.
Yeah. Pirate.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Is my totem animal. Only in that form.
Yes.
Pigeon form.
Right.
Tenderloin pigeon.
Yes. Tenderloin pegasus. All right. Pigeon.
Sorry. Sorry.
Very who serious. Bestows her magic powers of sewing and pattern drafting and imagination. To
just
help
like all pigeons.
Yep. And Jordan LaForge. To help us in it's like reading rainbow.
It is.
Yeah.
Are we on Netflix?
Sweet.
It's taking a look. It's in a book. It's reading rainbow.
Reading rainbow.
So I didn't watch that show as a child.
Do anything. I'll stop.
No.
Please.
So Keegan is part of our cast, and she is helping us draft these amazing Star Trek swim through space outfit uniforms for us,
it's
for our routine. Yes, it is a mouthful.
Mm-hmm.
So it is a mashup of the original uniform with a twist of Esther Williams' swimsuit. But I dare say a smidgen of Vegas.
Yeah.
Showgirl.
I would also say the Vegas
just
showgirl.
Just a dash, though.
Yeah.
I can't imagine why.
I can't imagine why. And we say this because two reasons. One, whilst we were getting the initial fitting on the Vanessa a couple of weeks ago, we insisted upon having the leg holes. Is that the term?
Leg part holes.
Yeah. Where the legs come out.
I think leg hole could be a technical term.
There's an armhole.
Right, an armhole is a word.
Thank you.
And I don't think you say legs eye, because you could say arms eye.
Mm-hmm.
But legs eye is, no?
No.
That doesn't work.
That sounds dirty.
Or like a turkey.
No, it's a baby.
Thanksgiving.
Yep. Mm. So the leg holes weren't... They weren't, I don't know, flashy enough. I don't know what we decided, but we decided to go Vegas showgirl on them because somebody has experience in that arena.
The pigeon.
Yeah, the pigeons.
Little bow ties.
So,
hats.
Super, yeah, right? Mm-hmm. Lots of rhinestones. Just all of them. Just literally dipped. So we made it kind of showgirly as well, but that's not Esther Williams because they were a little bit more modest. So we
like I said, a mere sprinkle.
Yeah.
A mere dash.
Like a dash.
A dazzle.
Ooh.
Of showgirl.
Ooh, I like it.
Yep.
That's a plural of showgirl. Mm-hmm. It's a dazzle of showgirl.
A dazzle of showgirl.
Mm-hmm. I like it.
So we're going to talk a little bit today about what material we used and why. We're going to talk about when we sewed our prototype slash first partial of our costume, what stitch we used and why we used that stitch. And at the very end, we're going to have a unveiling of the prototype, or not a prototype, but the
work in progress
of our first Star Trek uniform.
I am much excited.
Yeah. So will you share with everyone why we're using spandex as material?
No, it's a trade secret.
Bye. Okay. Well, all right. See you later, folks.
Bye.
Have a good night.
Thanks for watching.
Bye.
So, if you wanted to just stand beautifully in your tailored swimwear and freeze, you could use any fabric imaginable. You could make it out of whatever you wanted. You could make it out of gem encrusted ermine if that was your thing.
Could I make it out of
butterflies? Don't do it, poor animals.
No. Yes.
You could make it out of beetle wings. That was big in the olden times.
Mm-hmm. The Egyptian as well.
Mm-hmm. Right? Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm. Beetle wing embroidery. It's beautiful.
Yep.
I'm so good at not derailing this show.
No.
So that would be just fine, but if you wanted to, say, swim through space, or be able to move, or rescue a princess, or do a super badass roundhouse kick,
for example,
you wouldn't want your fabric to restrict you from doing any of those things, right? So when you are working with, let's just say, this beautiful tiger pouch fabric, ooh, which is luxurious and beautiful.
You can make it into a loincloth. Charlie Sheen, we don't want you. Go away.
It is a nice looking loincloth.
It is.
You will notice this doesn't really move when I pull on it, right? So if I had an extremely form-fitting tiger outfit.
Wow. Oh, wow.
And then I wanted to do a backflip, I would probably tear my fabric. And then that would be a tragedy.
It's a different show at that point. Yeah.
A tragedy. But if you take a fabric that is just a little bit more obnoxious than the tiger print one, that it is a knit fabric as opposed to a woven fabric, and this one also contains spandex, you will notice that this stretches in all of the ways. All of the stretches. So me and Lindsay could have a tug of war with this fabric,
and we would have
to work really hard if we wanted to tear it in two. The other great thing about this fabric is no matter how much we pull on it, well, I'm sure it has its limits, it recovers. And if it was just an ordinary knit fabric made of just regular cotton or a wool knit like a sweater, it has the same sort of give. But it won't bounce back like the spandex will. Mm-hmm. It will just bounce right back to its original shape. So you can create something that really hugs the body, but still allows full range of motion, which is exactly what you want in a super beautiful bathing beauty, synchronized swimming through space Star Trek uniform.
Also, Keegan is our Edna from the Incredibles. And if you think about your major supers that you see, Spider-Man, Superman, Batgirl, Wonder, no, not Wonder Woman really, because she has like some corset thing on with heels.
Which is not very functional.
Which is really not functional at all.
Unless you're Wonder Woman.
Unless you're Wonder Woman, but she deserves, Xena also had a similar
thing. Xena's wearing armor. That's different.
But fine. But Spider-Man and Superman and Batgirl tend to wear
Robin
spandex like suits, because when you're moving around and jumping around and kicking or flying or what have you.
What was the flying thing again?
On this?
Yeah, there
you go. That was the proper way. This way.
It was just like perfectly.
That was so good.
Well, have you ever seen Superman take off from a different position?
Point.
No.
Point. Nope. Unless he's being Powdered Toast Man from a
minute. And flies backwards.
Powdered Toast Man. Anyway, so a lot of the supers wear spandex-like suits because it has a lot of movement, a lot of stretch when they are roundhouse kicking people into the face.
Not Chuck Norris, though.
Who are not Chuck Norris because he wears denim.
That's because he's Chuck Norris.
True. And Chuck Norris don't
need those spandex. Chuck Norris can roundhouse kick in denim without popping any seams.
That's super impressive.
And we're not that.
We're not no. Chuck Norris.
Also, sweating in jeans is awful.
Ooh.
Mm. Not if you're Chuck Norris.
Unless you're
sweat.
Chuck Norris.
He doesn't sweat.
Mm-mm. Does the sweat cure cancer?
He sweats sugar.
Mm, so he's Potter Toast Man.
He is.
In spice. I don't know what to say.
I'm going
to
drink some more, though. That's what I'm going to do.
So anyway.
Nap.
Mm-hmm. That's why we use spandex.
That's why a lot of supers wear spandex. I know a lot of people in the cosplay community do spandex for their different costumes and whatnot. It is nice and forgiving. It's a pretty forgiving fabric. If you make it a little bit too small, it stretches. It's flattering. I like it. It's comfortable. And would you say that it wicks like moisture, like when you're sweating?
So nowadays, most of the sort of active wear fabrics that you find do tend to have some wicking technology. That's sort of a, you'll find that a lot in things called active wear fabric or technical fabric if you are out shopping for some spandex for your own superhero needs. I won't tell your secret identity.
We won't tell.
No. That would be a great thing to look for. Very useful when you are moving around a lot as a dancer or gymnast or superhero, any of those sorts of things. You could take advantage of that technology now.
And where can one get spandex material?
It's a lot more widely available than it used to be. You used to have to really search high and low to track down good quality stretch fabric. Nowadays you can find it in most fabric stores. Even Joann's carries some. A great place to start looking is fabric.com. I know that's super hard to remember, but they do tend to carry a great selection of stretch fabrics. Oh my god, here's the expert.
Is check, please tell the people about where you get your spandex.
He's so deep.
He doesn't wear spandex, he only wears natural fibers.
Oh.
Freaking hippies.
Thanks for having me. Something that is good to look for beyond the word spandex when you are shopping for fabric, especially if you're doing it on the internet, is Lycra, which is a trade name for spandex, patented by DuPont.
I did not know that.
Huh.
That's so cool. I thought they were two separate things.
Spandex is the generic term for Lycra.
Oh, no wonder I got so confused.
Oh. Another place, if you are in the Bay Area, I went to Fabric Discount.
Fabric Outlet.
Outlet.
Ooh.
Fabric Outlet.
I love you, Fabric Outlet.
Oh my gosh, you guys. If you haven't been there, check it out. It's in Mission.
Mission 17th. At the corner of 17th.
Right next door to like the three-story Goodwill or like Salvation Army or something.
Something.
Yeah. Anyway, it is a giant warehouse of, as far as you can, as the eye can see, fabric.
And I think right now they are having a sale on faux furs for all of your Burning Man needs.
Are we surprised?
It is that time of year.
Hi, burners. Have fun out there in the
Have
dirt.
Have fun in here. Yeah.
We'll be here.
Yeah.
So wearing spandex.
Spandex. Marginally better, you know.
So when you're working with spandex, because it's so stretchy, and let's say I want to start out on my project, does it matter which way I'm sewing it?
That is a great question. So oftentimes when you are taking a project, especially if you're working from a commercial pattern, there will be a green line marked on the pattern. And that tends to indicate, you know, if you have a woven fabric, there are fibers that go this way and fibers that go this way. Hence, it's a weave, right? Mm-hmm. So generally the arrow will indicate the lengthwise grain of your fabric.
Ah, the lengthwise.
However, when you are working with a knit, all of the fibers are kind of interlocked this way, right? They're looped around each other, just like if you can picture kind of a loose knit sweater and the way that the cables will be knit there. Mm-hmm. So this is just the same thing on a really, really tiny scale. So you will do well to find for yourself fabrics that say they are four-way stretch. That means that they will stretch about as much across as they do lengthwise. In general, most fabrics do tend to have a little bit more stretch in one direction than the other. So when you're placing your pattern pieces, if you are sewing yourself an awesome Green Man suit or something, you would want to make sure that you're putting the stretch on that grain line for your pattern, the greatest amount of stretch, so that it will move more with your body. Mm-hmm. If you're designing your own patterns or just like draping something all on your own, you can think about that and play with it a little bit. In the pattern that I made for this costume, we made sure that we kept the stretch going around the body in the front pieces, but have some pieces on the side where the stretch is going vertically to the body so that it makes it easier to bend sideways and such and so forth.
Nice. Excellent.
You're amazing, and I like listening to you talk with your mouth parts.
It's because I ramble a lot.
No, you're awesome.
Good.
I'm sad we did not have the vent today for our World of Warcraft. It makes it far more boring.
It happened too fast because you're a stupid tank person, and so cues don't take 45 minutes, and I didn't know what to do.
I'm sorry.
You're welcome. Well, I like it.
And you too.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You're my friend.
I just want to go on a picnic with you guys in Azeroth.
Can we? It's so much fun. She's got a picnic basket and there's hearts that kind of just float out.
I would like to go on a picnic.
We have to get you into it. And we should. Do you want to be a healer?
Can I be a rogue dragon?
Yes,
you can be a rogue dragon.
You can be a rogue
dragon.
You can name you dragon.
I only play when I can be a dragon who's a rogue.
You could be a drainer.
You can be a rogue who is an alchemist, and then you can make a device that will literally turn you into a dragon, and we can ride you.
There we go.
Yeah, but I look like a griffin, but I'm not a dragon.
Okay.
Also a rogue.
Yeah. So, mm-hmm. Yeah.
I have the head of a eagle and a body of a lion and hands like a lion, but back legs like an eagle, but I'm not a griffin. I'm a dragon, and I'm also a rogue. Also, I have a theme song.
Vanessa is my spirit animal, but it's only true. In that form.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And yes, you can ride me, but you can't have a saddle.
No. So we have to hold on to your hair.
Tame. Like Chris Pratt.
Yeah. Like
this. This. Like this.
Like that. Okay. Yeah. And then that's how you do it. Also, you're allowed to raid my mane.
Can we?
Yeah.
Well, we need something to do while we're flying across that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Only if it's with those pink brushes from my little puppies.
Ooh.
Yeah,
that's right.
Mm-hmm. I'll protect you guys.
It's good.
I'll have big wings of shield power.
Can we go gank noobs?
Yeah.
Because friendship is magic. Am I crossing too many streams?
No, cross all of the seams.
While we're swimming through space. Ah,
sun punch!
Yay!
Did you say crossing the
seams?
Seams?
Yes. Waka waka.
Oh, I love you.
Meanwhile, back in the sewing conversation.
Oh yes, what a great way to tie that in.
Thanks, Tech Andy.
He keeps us from going down the shiny tangent rat hole.
He's our adult.
I shall defeat you.
Mm-hmm. Challenge accepted.
Is there anything that we're missing as far as long way stretch versus side to side stretch? In which way?
Is there a good way for people to figure that out?
Pull on your fabric.
Mm-hmm. Well, there you go.
Frequently when you are working from a store-bought pattern, there will be a little guide on the back of your pattern where it tells you how much fabric you should buy, which is good, and you should look at that. There's sometimes a little, like it looks like a little ruler that would say 4 inches of fabric should stretch from here to here. And that's another great way to make sure that the fabric you're using has enough stretch and enough recovery to accommodate the pattern that you are sewing with.
Cool. So because you didn't have a store-bought pattern because you're amazing and you made this pattern, how did you determine whether your fabric was stretchy enough?
I guessed.
Super precise science. All right.
All of the science.
Yep.
Keegan wore a lab coat and goggles while
I did
it.
And then I pushed this button like this on the internet and was like, buy it!
Big, red, shiny, candy-like button.
Oh, yeah.
That's a goofy.
Not push that.
Also, sometimes the internet will tell you wonderful things like, this fabric is 92% polyester and 4% lycra and 2%, we're not going to tell you. And it contains, you know, 4-way stretch, and it's 15% stretch on this grain and 20% stretch on the length grain.
Mm.
So that can also give you an idea. I'm not a smart man, so I don't do the percents. I just pull on things.
Mm. Super scientific.
Yeah.
Before they had the math, they did the pulley stuff. So I feel like
I'm doing it old school.
Really old school.
Also, I think the internet's a liar, so I'm not always confident that those percentages are going to be accurate.
That's how Esther Williams did it.
You know what? It's true.
So
says we.
We're way more that way.
Yeah, we're so valid right now.
Super duper. So we're also going to talk about which stitches to use best when working with stretch fabric.
Aha!
So when I'm at my sewing machine, and I'm definitely still learning and very, very new and beginner at the very terrifying. I mean, wonderful world of sewing.
Terrifying.
Am I gonna want to just use a straight stitch?
So you could, but you might not get the greatest results from that, right? Oftentimes people will recommend sewing your knit fabrics and your stretch fabrics in particular with a serger, which is a super fancy piece of equipment that uses 4 or 5 or 2 or 3 giant spools of thread.
It's like a tornado of thread.
It is a tornado of thread. That is what it says on the box. Or it should, anyway.
Damn it.
One day I'll take over and that's what will happen.
But you're the ministry.
On our regular sewing machines, it just says, I'm going to be HR in hell. That's going to be my job.
I can only hope.
Will you have a puppet that looks like a dolphin?
Or maybe a hermit crab. Oh, to explain the no-no bits and where
no.
Oh,
okay. I will not be using a puppet.
Oh, will you be using a pineapple?
This is hell. Hades.
It's hell. Come on.
A pomegranate?
No, you're like Sisyphus right now. And you're trying to make it happen. So it's not going to happen. So it's there, so that was, layers.
Good. Somebody's just like on fire today.
It's the spider. Ah! Sex shark! Ah!
Hello. Well, where did the demon touch you?
It's Shark Week, so it's very appropriate right now.
It's all right.
You, why are you British?
I'm.
They don't have sharks.
A little Cockney and a little British and a little Australian.
Okay, Australian, I would understand
mate.
From a shark.
Mate.
Put another shrimp on the Barbie.
Thanks, Ted.
Sheep shag and kiwi.
Ooh.
Nice.
Apologies for our
oceanic sewing and stitching
things. Sewing.
Not a character in World of Warcraft. Stitches.
Do you know that there's a pet called Stitches Jr. that shows up in my garrison sometimes?
Really? Is he a horrifying with like a baby Stitches? When he's little, it's fine.
It's adorable.
You could play Stitches in Heroes of the Storm, and he's upsetting because he throws out a chain of death.
I like Stitch from Lilo and Stitch.
I want to say you are not prepared.
Yeah, he's an unmurderous asshole. Anyway,
let's say, okay, like a normal person, you didn't have a serger available to yourself, and you just had your regular fancy pants sewing machine that has a needle thread and a bobbin thread. And you could take your machine and loosen up the tension and make your stitch width really tiny and pull on your fabric a little as you sewed it in hopes that that stitch would hold together. But more often than not, when you're working with a knit fabric and a fabric that stretches, it's going to be way easier to use a zigzag stitch, which looks exactly how it sounds, like a little zigzag, as opposed to a straight line.
Evasive maneuvers.
Exactly, serpentine. So that the fabric has a little bit more give in your seams. And there's a lot of different sizes and styles of zigzag stitch depending on your sewing machine in particular. I tend to like to sew my knits with both my sewing machine and the serger if I have one available. So I'll kind of do a narrow zigzag on my seam first, and once I know that I'm really happy with it and the fit is good and everything looks smooth, then I'll run it through the serger. That way there's two different separate independent lines of stitching that will prevent it from busting, we hope, no matter how many amazing backflips I do through windows.
Or tumbles in outer space.
Or backstrokes. Dragon hair braiding.
Fights with tumbleweeds. Yeah.
You know. Dragon hair braiding. Mm-hmm. Not griffins.
Oh, not griffins.
No, not griffins. Nobody ever braids a griffin's hair.
No. But they do braid dragon hair.
Rogue dragon.
Mane.
Rogue dragon.
Sorry.
Mane.
Not hair.
Rogue dragon. Rogue dragon. With a really long tail. Rogue dragon.
Like dragons do.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Science. Claws.
So this is super exciting. I know it's just a piece of fabric, but I'm like,
yeah. So it's actually going to go right like
this. I know.
That's Lindsay's piece.
I'm totally not feeling her up yet.
Well, okay, kind of.
You. I'm so excited.
See? It's like an outfit.
Ooh, I'm ready, guys.
I suppose this is what the kids wear to the club.
I think so.
Right? Yeah, just like it. Put a ribbon on it and you'd be good to
go. We need like candy necklaces, though.
Can we?
Yeah.
Okay. Beads. We'll be right back.
So we're going to take a break.
Yeah.
And then in our, we'll do some Q&A for anything that we either spoke over too fast, or if you want to geek out on World of Warcraft more, or about talking about more about Rogue Dragon and who that is, or talking about sewing, but why.
We'll do that.
Yep. Yep. And then we will go into the implementation after our Q&A, where we'll show you how to do a zigzag stitch and what we've done.
Yes.
So far, which is very exciting. And what happens when you sew a straight stitch versus a zigzag stitch? What happens?
Who knows?
Science!
Science!
We'll be back.
Okay. You want to be on the internet, Izzy? Come here.
The cat wants to be on the internet, and it needs a super space suit made out of spandex.
And some bread for his face.
And it needs some bread for its face.
Keegan.
It's sad.
That's upsetting.
It's a school night children.
That is upsetting. Mm-hmm.
Welcome to the Q&A portion of our show.
Can I answer all the questions in cat?
Yes.
Please do. Izzy has a question.
Izzy, how can I help you? I don't really understand how that's relevant.
He doesn't quite. Oh.
Okay.
Cat butt.
Oh. He's going to help us sew the costumes.
He knows all about sewing machines.
Well, good night, folks. We're just gonna
see you later.
Yep. All right.
We have a cat, so we're bored of you.
Yes. Who needs?
Also, cats are. Any questions? Anything? Andy's laughing. There's a cat bud.
Well, but it's the eye of Sauron.
I'm thinking a big black dot to just like nuts. suitable for children.
Censored.
Censored.
Where's that 5-second TV delay?
Tonight on Cosplay Cabaret Workshop, cats gone wild!
That's what happened.
He just got offended with what
no,
he said.
No, he liked it.
I'm going to take your hairs. Oh, hello, sweetie.
I'm sorry, internet.
I want to know how you both visioned the costumes.
Hand me your model first.
Okay.
That's a great question.
Yeah, I wanted, because I know Keegan and Lindsay had a Skype conference on visioning how they wanted the costumes to look. I wasn't present for that, which is fine with me because I was so pleasantly surprised. But I'd love to hear about how that came to be. How did the vision come to be?
Well, I will start with what my initial concept was. And it was basically like the TV show had the super mod-esque Starfleet uniforms, right? Like it's very 60s chic with the boots and like the colors and the weight of the things designed. And that's super cheesy to me. I know that some of the Trekkies out there will be super offended because I dare say it's cheesy.
At least you're not offending Star Wars fans.
I would never do that.
They'll murder you.
They will. In my sleep, they know where I live.
That is his now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I know.
Okay.
I know.
That's you earned it.
You work so hard.
That's right.
I rubbed on it.
It's like Pretty Woman. You don't know how, but it is.
Costumes, why?
I think that most people who are cosplayers or make costumes would agree. One of the most fun parts of coming up with your costume is the research. Mm-hmm. Is looking at, you know, how have other people done this? Has anyone done this?
That's right.
What are the differences between a Starfleet officer's uniform versus a Starfleet medic's uniform? What are the differences from the original series versus Next Generation versus Deep Space Nine?
All of the stuff.
Versus Enterprise? And which way do you want to go? Like, what is the look that you're trying to portray?
Right.
So we ended up working mostly with the idea of the Next Generation uniforms because they seemed the easiest to translate into a swimsuit type form.
Mm-hmm.
But I did, when we had our meeting, draw out extremely poorly because I am not an artist.
It was very great.
A number of very tiny little versions of some different ideas that we could look at and discuss the pros and cons of why a cute little mod 60s dress made of double knit may or may not be better than a leotard made in the style of a Next Generation jumpsuit.
That's right. That's right. So we went with the leotard thing because it was so true to the Esther Williams kind of the cats, like, wee, webcam, Izzy.
The webcam is now his checks.
Do you want to come up here? Do you want a leotard?
Yeah, we're going to make Izzy a super suit.
Ooh.
He's going to be the honorary dance captain for this number.
Oh, we need somebody who's an adult for us. So we went with the leotards because it is it's a synchronized swim through space kind of routine. And I wanted to have something that would translate well, both that is recognizable to the super fans of Star Trek, of which I am honestly not. Like, I'm a fan of it, but not like super.
Unless we're talking about Will Wheaton.
Even then.
Wesley Crusher.
Wait, 12-year-old Will Wheaton?
12-year-old Wesley Crusher?
Yeah.
Really?
12 or 30?
For 12-year-old me?
Oh, not at all. Okay.
I liked it. I mean, season 2, he looks a little better.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, a little bit, I don't know, less whiny. Season 1, just not.
I liked him whiny.
Anyway, so we went with the Next Generation.
Yes.
A little bit of that homage in our Star Trek suits.
So. That's right. And then, so we wanted to stay close to kind of, again, the line of the Esther Williams synchronized swimming thing, because that's what this whole number is supposed to also pay homage to, is that super cheesy swimsuit.
Olympic level.
Totally, right?
Swim cap, slicked back hair, giant amounts of mascara, Vaseline on your face.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yep. Mm-hmm. That's what's happening.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. And so we're deciding to pair our little Starfleet costumes with fishnets, and we should decide what kind of shoes we're gonna do.
I think black tee straps
as well. And I'm not sure what to do with the hair. We once talked about fishing, like swimming caps.
Swimming caps. Oh, bye.
Sorry, Izzy.
See you later.
He does not like nap tangle.
I'm really into swimming caps. Honestly. I'm really into the swimming caps.
Yeah, so.
With a chin strap.
So I am also, right?
Because not instant funny. Glamour, like a chin strap.
Instant funny.
That's true. But also, there's also talk of like the 60s bouffant. So we were like, again, crossing the Star Trek stream here, going between Next Gen and the original OG.
Also, I kind of want to have Uhura's hair. The big high ponytail,
right?
Because I could do it.
Right,
it would look awesome.
We could do the Uhura hair, which I would be fine with. Although some of our cast may not be able to do that.
Well, I think that your hair should be different.
I think it should be because.
Or I'm just the only one in a swimming cap.
Yes,
that would actually be really funny. That would tie into the thing really well. So this number, and I'm not sure if you guys have followed along with our show.
Hold on, swimming cap
with a hole
for my giant ponytail. And in the very beginning, I snap my chin snap strap.
That's so funny.
I'm a pretty princess rogue dragon.
Oh, that would be so great. So at the beginning, so the whole point of this number is that there's a joke at the end. And yes, we do get it. We know what red shirts mean.
Wait, I'm sorry.
Are you sure?
Are you sure you understand?
I can mansplain it to you.
You know, I had somebody tell me, do you know what that means? And I'm like, that's the whole.
That's why there's one red shirt.
That's why the red shirt is
sparkly. Oh,
you guys, because Commander Riker wears red shirts. Ooh.
Yeah. He doesn't start Rikering chairs until season 2, I realized. It was very exciting. He gets the beard, and he starts right.
Once he gets
the
beard, man, all bets are off with
it's
that
true.
Dude. Like you can't. You gotta get out of the
intro
way.
Whoopi Goldberg, which is also very exciting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Anyway, yes, we get the joke.
We do.
Please don't mansplain it.
Yeah. Also, if you want to see the joke, you should probably come to one of our shows. It's hilarious.
Any questions out there in the world?
Yay! Thanks, guys.
Thanks. I have a question.
Is it a question for the world?
It's a question for you, which also equals the world. Don't screw this one up, Keegan. But
no pressure.
Where did you learn how to draft patterns? Because I looked at the things. Do you have it here? Can we show the people?
Yeah, it's somewhere.
The glory.
It's in a different room.
Okay, well.
Which, for the pattern?
Yeah.
What room is it in?
Keegan, in her infinite wisdom, drafted a pattern. And I don't know if you guys know anything about the sewing, or if you do, you probably have some inkling. But drafting a pattern for anything is super upsetting and confusing and requires Lindsay to drink copious amounts of alcohol to even deal with the fact that it's upsetting. So Keegan here did that, and it's awesome, and it's amazing, and it works. So there's numbers involved.
There is numbers. There is some math. There's fractions.
Nope. It's very scary.
It's less scary than you think. You know, anytime that you are working with pattern making, whether you do draping or you do flat pattern making, which is what I used in this case, you are basically taking something that is three-dimensional, big body.
Hi, I'm a body.
Body!
It's a nice body. Mm-hmm. And you are turning it into something flat so that you can cut it out of the fabric and then turning it into something three-dimensional again, which can be worn on said body.
Body.
So there's a little bit of a weird conversion that happens there. I learned to sew because my mother was a seamstress and would make all of my super badass Halloween costumes when I was young.
Thanks, Mom.
Myself and my brother. I love you, Mom! So the first thing that I ever sewed was actually a tiny little Victorian hat to wear with my Halloween costume where I was Anna from Anna and the King of Siam.
Oh, nice.
And I went trick-or-treating and everyone said to me, oh, look, it's Cinderella. And I was furious.
Ew.
Gross.
Side note, my younger brother was the Flash that year.
Really?
He wore spandex.
Well, there you go.
Wow.
See how good I derail things?
But you brought it back.
It's relevant.
I brought it back around. Not really.
It is.
I just pulled the e-brake. So, pattern drafting is something I'm relatively new to. A dear mutual friend of ours actually assisted me with my very first attempts of pattern drafting recently. So it's all new and shiny and exciting for me to do. And as long as you take it slowly and double check yourself a lot to make sure that you haven't done crazy math.
Or wrecked yourself. Keeping it real.
Homies.
I just can't even.
I'm healthy.
You're so healthy. You're the most healthy person in my life.
I'm an enabler.
It's definitely fun to work with. I'm sure anyone who is making their own super awesome badass costumes out there knows sometimes you get a pattern and you buy all of this fabric and you make this big investment and you're super stoked and then you sew it all up and for some reason this shoulder is like this or it's too long for your body or too short for your body. And that's super disappointing. So once you start to delve into altering your patterns, you're basically pattern drafting already. So it's something that I encourage people to experiment with. It's fun.
All right, we're gonna go to a break and then we're actually going to get to some sewing, zigzag stitch, straight stitch, and then we will reveal to you our work in progress.
Jazz hands.
Oh.
Am I doing this right?
Yeah. Mercy bucket.
Hello! Meow!
Oh, alright. So we have a question. Could you repeat the question?
The question was, do you ever use a dress form?
What a good question. I love working with a dress form. It's a little bit tricky to, my dress form doesn't have separating legs or arms. So with something like a leotard, it's a little bit less helpful than if I was making something like a dress. Also a little difficult for pants. But it is a great way, especially if you're making something for your own self, to be able to check your fit if you have a dress form that is a good double of you. There are also some amazing tutorials across the internet of ways that you can get a friend, yes you, to help you make your own dress form out of duct tape or paper mache so that you end up with a perfect match of your body, provided you never change size.
No, not a sex doll. And correct me if I'm wrong, you do that when you wear like a long sleeve shirt and some pants that you don't care about too much, maybe some leggings, and then you literally duct tape yourself up many, many, many layers from about your collarbone all the way down. And then after many layers of using that duct tape, you take some EMT shears or medical shears and then cut up through your duct tape dummy and then stuff it. Mm-hmm. Is that correct? And then it's a pretty somewhat cheap way of making a dress form.
Yeah, that is customized to you, which I am all about. Unless, of course, you are claustrophobic.
Not for you. So what Keegan's doing right now is working on our first costume. She is sewing up the sides of the tunic of our leotard. One side she is going to be using a straight stitch, so not that zigzag stitch that she was talking about what she recommends you use for working with stretch fabrics. The other side of the costume, she is going to be using a zigzag stitch. And we're gonna do an experiment to see what happens when yours truly,
Guinea Pig!
Puts it on to see if what will occur.
And here, I can even do a little test while we are awaiting my slow self to get this done.
You are not slow, just mentally.
Oh, love.
I know.
I finally have friends who understand me. Yay. And respect me as a person.
I did respect you until you started sewing the lion's colors.
Oh. Oh, this isn't my fault. Mm-hmm. I didn't choose these colors.
It chose me, the lion's lunch. Sorry. I can't sew, so I'm here for comedic relief. I'm like C-3PO, like really.
Beep, 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 beep.
Which I'm fine with. Keegan is using a Singer sewing machine.
This is fancy.
Yeah, it's super duper fancy. It has a blue LED light.
Since
which is awesome.
1851. Thanks, Hot Fiance.
Ooh, Hot Fiance is responsible for
really?
Sewing machine from space.
Well, Stupid Me may have broken my other sewing machine.
Not stupid, smart, because you got super sewing machine from space by Hot Fiance. Like, that was not stupid, way smarter. Sewing machines brought to you by Hot Fiancés and 2015.
Probably longer
than that. But keeping your Hot Fiance since 2015.
Yeah.
No, 2014. Last year.
That's right.
That's right. I remember because Dickens Fair was like, oh my god!
Yep.
If you don't know, I'll teach you.
Stop it. So, here we go. We have made, and maybe you can make that visible,
ooh,
a little straight stitch and a little zigzag stitch.
Might need to bring it closer, like down here.
And the zigzag stitch that I used is pretty narrow.
This is the straight stitch.
You can see even just with the stitches.
This is the zigzag stitch.
That my beautiful assistant is demonstrating for you.
Vanna
Rogue Dragon.
Vanna
Rogue Dragon. Rogue
Dragon.
You can see that the section that I sewed with the zigzag versus the section I sewed with the straight stitch is actually a little bit smoother all on its own. The straight stitch section is a little bit bunched up because the fabric gets stretched a little bit as you bring it through the presser foot of your machine.
Wow, we have Tech Andy actually.
And then Tech Andy, go ahead and like pull on that zigzagged section.
Ooh, cool!
See how it's like springy!
Yeah!
Whee!
That's so
and
cool!
And then give a little tug to that straight stitch section.
Oh, that's not very
good.
The fabric
still has its stretch and recover, but the stitches don't really move with it in the same way.
That's so cool!
Science.
When you are done, may I see, darling?
Mm-hmm. All right, so we have zigzag.
Cool.
And then with the straight stitch, I'm pulling it and I just broke it.
Uh-oh! So this, you guys, this is not what you want to have happen when it's on your body.
Unless it's that kind of show.
Unless you want
Yeah, if you're making breakaway pants,
awesome.
Yeah.
That's a way.
Straight. Yeah, I just went to stretch out that straight stitch and it popped. It all popped out.
Neat.
Oops. Yes, you can still see it.
Yay!
But yeah, I mean, I wasn't even applying that much force. And I can only imagine when we're moving around and dancing, that would pop so fast.
Cool.
So quickly. So who knew that a simple thing like sewing a zigzag versus sewing straight.
And I totally forgot this very important piece of information, which I'm sure anyone that would be watching this show is super smart and knew this already, but I would be a terrible, terrible seamstress if I did not remind you that when you are sewing a knit fabric, you should always use a ballpoint needle. Even better if you want to use a stretch needle. I'm not really sure how they're different, but the stretch needle mm-hmm. seems to work great when you are inserting elastic, which is definitely something that we will be doing in these costumes. Mm-hmm. It helps to prevent the little rubber from popping through the right side of your fabric while you sew. But absolutely use a ballpoint needle when you are sewing knits. The ballpoint needle is just a little bit rounded off rather than a super sharp tip. So it will kind of fit in between those little interlocking knits of the fabric rather than pierce holes in it.
And you can get that at any like Joann's Fabrics or
Absolutely.
Your local sewing shop.
Neat.
Yes, not hard to find at all.
I would imagine that the sharp, pointy needles would kind of destroy the integrity of the fabric. We don't want that.
Correct. We want these to stay together. So working with your ballpoint needles and even ballpoint pins, I'm a big supporter of ballpoint pins versus your sharp-headed straight pins as you are sewing to help prevent poking unnecessary holes in the knit of your fabric.
Mm. Neat. The more you know.
Hooray!
Huzzah. So this is what we've been working on. This is what we worked on over the weekend. It was very exciting because I got to learn how to sew points.
Which is like pretty varsity shit.
Yeah, right? Well, I had a very
yes.
good teacher.
You did it though, and you're amazing. Take it.
Okay, take it. I was helped a lot by text pictures.
It was amazing.
On Sunday, I was texting Keegan many, many, many photos. Like, and this is me pinning it.
it was really
and,
so great.
And yeah. this is me at the sewing machine. It was really great.
Right? It was wonderful to see her step by step progress.
Yep.
As she kind of problem solved it and figured out how to do her work even better.
It was very stressful, but
it was a great documentary though. Like,
yeah, right? It was really cool to see.
That was not intentional.
It well,
but I'm glad that it turned out okay.
Yeah.
Is it time that I can put it on now?
Yeah, do you want to do a fit test here?
Yes. So this is the reveal.
Out of the way.
I'll hold this.
You take that. Don't die, sewing machine. I love you.
No death.
Okay.
No dying.
So cool.
So this is what we worked on. This is the first one. And this is
oh, my God, looks so good.
Oh, man.
So we are a work in progress here. There's obviously parts that are not yet attached.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Guys, hold on.
Can you take a picture?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Wait. Well, no, we'll wait until that.
Yes. I love it. Oh my gosh, that's so great. Sorry, it's self-air.
Very exciting.
Oh my god.
So as you can see, we have a red color here.
Yes, we know. What?
Huh? Mm. And then we have our chevron here. I sewed this chevron, but all by myself. So that's our homage to Next Generation, of course. We're going to be adding some fantastic sleeves.
Disco dot.
Disco
sequin dust.
Sequin sleeves.
Yep.
And then, of course, how can you forget from last week's episode, our...
The bling.
That's right.
Ding, ling, ling, ling.
You need to be a bit lower.
Mm. Yeah. Ding, ling, ling.
Here we go.
And this, of course, will be trimmed and then glued on. We will flash blind the entire audience.
That should be the goal of every
performer. I'm such a proud parent right now.
I hand glued each one of these. I did.
I hand glued.
There's about over 100 crystals glued on here.
You're so fancy.
Glued that. Yeah. Finished it yesterday along with my
chevron.
Cool. So here it is. Prototype. It's so exciting. And which side is the...
Gosh, now I don't even remember. This side looks like it was the zigzaggy side.
Yep.
This side, uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Oh, look at that.
Already?
It's already, maybe that was me not sewing it all the way down. Actually, you know, that could be me. I was so nervous that when I sewed the chevron, I'm like, I'm done.
I'm stopping.
I'm stopping.
Pull your head.
So if I stand up, my head will be cut off, but that's okay.
Ooh, you like your head, but it's okay. Yeah, so the side with the zigzag stitch over here, you can see it sort of sitting a little tighter and smoother. And over here, where she has the straight stitch side, when we put the fabric under a little bit of stress, it doesn't really hold as well.
Mm-mm. Nope.
Yeah, wow, you can give.
You can see it already just beginning to stretch open.
Yeah.
So, and when we're moving around, we're really going to want to have the insurance of the zigzag stitch. So here's what we have thus far. It's so very exciting.
I'm so excited. I love the height of the leg.
Yeah, this is how high it's going to be. I'm a little nervous. I'm very nervous then.
No, it's gonna be super awesome.
I'm very nervous.
Oh man.
More like
that. Yeah,
oh,
buddy.
Geez.
We had some nice butt hanging out as well.
Yep. Why do you want to see that?
Because.
And then here we are. So very, very rough and raw. But this is what it looks like so far. And then we'll have others, of course, in yellow and blue. But this is the only disco red one.
The only red.
And it may involve a disco red swim cap. Who knows?
I'm so proud of your work.
Yeah.
You did a great job.
The only part that I did was this part.
But you did a great job.
It looks
great.
Well, I'm very flattered.
I think that's the hardest part to sew, is that front point.
I had a very good teacher. Also, I blame pictures and text messages and lots of emojis.
Yeah.
Emojis solve everything.
Yep. I'm sad, though, that they're not comprehensive. They don't have sharks.
No.
Yes, they
or
do.
Coffins.
Nope.
No sharks.
Nope.
You checked.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Many times. We have shark week, right?
Ooh, haha.
Right? Can't do that without sharks.
Well. The shark!
See?
Every month with you!
Why?
Hello.
Chum the waters.
Frenzy.
Ah.
Alright. So everyone, that is the most of our show, most all of our show, most all at the end of our show.
When you get to the end,
stop. So we're going to stop. Next week, we are going to do a big show and tell of all of the projects that we've worked on. So we're going to bring back our favorite box step.
Yep.
Our M-Class Planet,
yep.
Our bedazzled insignia, a completed rhinestoned, awesome Starfleet Esther Williams swimsuit, and then chat a little bit about what our next project will be. We've been booked for our first gig.
Yep.
So we'll do a little bit of a teaser as what will be next for Cosplay Cabaret. Keegan, thank you so much for being on
thank
the show.
Thank you guys for letting me stink up your stream.
You're wonderful and magical, like a unicorn that's made out of other unicorns.
And pigeons.
And lots of pigeons.
Thanks again Misscliks for putting their hopes, faith, and dreams in us.
And reputation.
We hope you don't regret it.
It's your regret.
Follow them on their, they're having a new D&D campaign coming up.
Yes, you are joining them.
People may be a part of it.
Yes, they have Vanessa doing a crossing the stream.
Can I rogue dragon?
Please be rogue dragon, Misscliks. Please, can I be rogue dragon?
I think you just
Please, can I be rogue dragon?
I think you just claim it.
And I just want to be rogue dragon. Okay, and then please follow us on Facebook.
Not Instagram, but the YouTube as well.
And follow on this Twitch. Craziness that is us.
Yeah. Thanks guys so much for watching, and we will see you all, same bad time, same awesome channel, next week.
Live long and prosper, yo.
Yeah, bitches.
Yeah, may the force be with you. Thank you.